blown up on that play. Back at the 20. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
On second and 12, Rodgers. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is the NFC rating offensive player of the week. You got to think, all the guys that take the field each and every week, that's not an easy award. Always has to feel good to grab it.
It has to feel great because it separates you, at least for a week, amongst your peers. And for him to separate again, he has to have the same type of a game. That means being explosive off the line of scrimmage and catching everything that comes his way.
Give him 18 on that play, and Green Bay has the first as well. Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. Pretty much unreal, not just in terms of yardage, Charles, but also throwing the three touchdowns as well.
When you put the whole package together, I can make you a pretty good guarantee right now. He's going to see a few more people in the box every time he lines up.
Yeah, I don't think that the defense has any choice. They've got to stop him. Can't let a repeat performance like that.
Agreed.
Shotgun now. Here's an inside give. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. A gain of just a yard, but it's a first down.
Defensively here, you're facing a top-five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high-powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic number. 20-point score, give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again. Rodgers. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 16 yards, a first down.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So second catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, two catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up the running game, too. And he'll get this one down to about the 27. The running back, Barkevious Mingo, in that time on the tackle.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
On second and 9, Rodgers, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. The third down battle won by Atlanta's defense. Solid coverage. On fourth down, the Falcons trot out the rookie punter from Syracuse, Sterling Hoffrichter, as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And he was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. 51 yards on the punt there. And it'll be Packer football here, first down and 10. About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. And last time able to get 3. It's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. These two teams all tied after 1. Now a handoff here to his running back. And they're going to have this. this across midfield and inside the 45. A big run there, 29 yards and a first. Well, this is the reigning NFC Offensive Player of the Week. Runs like that might get him another award.
Yeah, Thunderbolt right out of the gate, huh? How about that, hitting the defense hard early? And, of course, carrying the momentum from last week into this week's game.
And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Up from his linebacker spot, Deion Jones making the play. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
Yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
And again, this time to the tailback. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and nine.
Sometimes being a linebacker in the middle of the field is kind of like being a doctor on the field. You got to make the right diagnosis. Here he correctly sets his run and shoots through to make the play in the backfield.
And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Rodgers pass intended for Devontae Adams. Incomplete.
Here's Sterling Hoffrichter now as he'll punt it away for the second time. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. That's fielded at the 8-yard line. 62 yards on the punt that time. Wow. And the Packer drive will start from deep in their own territory with a first and 10. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a second and 3, second and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. You don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
Right back to him on first down. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And the hole closes quickly there. He gets maybe a couple up to the 38. The Packers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 8.
Makes it third and 8.
Throwing is Rodgers. He's going to find his running back. It's complete.
Rodgers pass.
Running back, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. It's a pickup of 3, and we have now arrived at the 2-minute warning. Our score 10-3 with 2 minutes remaining in quarter number 2. Coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
And a give this time to the tailback. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Rodgers in control as he hurries his guys to the line. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now a handoff here to his running back. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A big chunk on the ground there, 27 yards. Got to give a nod of appreciation to some of those guys up front over on that left side. Several key blocks sprung him.
No appreciation for the guys from the backside that didn't allow any leakage, and if anybody could run him down from the backside.
They're at the kids' table.
Okay, so front side guys, good, yeah. Backside guys.
Meh.
That's what you're supposed to do?
I've had better.
Okay, either way. Worked out quite well, didn't it? A nice sizable gain.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Well, they've had success on the ground on this drive, and that makes a defense more likely to overcommit to stop the run as they did on that play. But keep in mind, it makes them susceptible to play-action passes as well.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. The eighth play of the drive coming up. It's third and 3.
Let's go, team. Big series right here. We got to step it up. 45 the mic. 45 the mic. Kid. Watch the ship. Watch the ship. Hey, watch the ship. Watch the ship.
Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. Now the Falcons gonna use. They'll start the third quarter here on the ground. That he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage. You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
Give him 15 there, and the Packers have a first.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a buck 50 now, and this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. On play action, now Rodgers. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
But the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
It's a gain of 4. Brings up 3rd and 6.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
I remember when Al Mazzard came out of Iowa State, many questioned his speed and wondered if he could separate from defenders downfield. He got pressed into action in the middle of last year due to injury for Green Bay. and wound up second on the team in receiving yards as he developed and got better each and every week. Remember that Monday night game against the Bears, partner? A late touchdown and a big comeback victory.
Brings up second and 11 at the Falcons' 42-yard line.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 4 yards on the pickup there, and now they're left with a third and 8.
Can we just take that run and turn it into a kind of a clip and save? Because that tells you everything you need to know about this drive. They've been moving the ball awfully well.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And a good job on the tackle there as they get him down shy of the first on the 35-yard stripe. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to fourth down.
Fourth down.
Going to give this time to the tailback. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and 4.
Daron Harmon on the
That's screen. A really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. A lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw
it. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. A great effort there with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Packers are within an extra point of tying it. The Falcons send out their punter as he's on to kick it away. This will be fielded at the 17. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. An excellent return that time, 26 yards. And that will come the offense as they take over. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. He has a chance to hit that often elusive 200-yard mark on this drive.
Most of the time during a game, people aren't keeping track of individual statistics.
Are you sure?
Well, a lot of the runners kind of know. But I'll guarantee you, someone has sent word into the offensive line that he's got a chance to get over 200 on this drive. That should give them a little extra motivation. Let's break that barrier.
Absolutely. We'll see if he can do it. The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Now Rodgers. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. 22 yards there, a first down.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss.
A toss play to the right.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Down right around the 25.
The running back again.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. Give this time to the tailback.
Number 21.
Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Well, it's hard to have vision as a runner and find a hole when there's nothing but defenders in your way. They stacked that one up really well. But give him credit. Instead of trying to bounce it out and turn it into a big play, which might have turned into a big loss, Kai just took his medicine there and took the 1 yard.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Rodgers gonna throw. Man open, that's Marquez Valdez-Scantling. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Pretty good games all weekend. We may have saved the best for last. This Monday night game has been a dandy. On first and 10, here's Rodgers. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and 6. And he'll give it here to his running back. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Now a handoff here to his running back. He'll get forward for 3 down to the 16-yard line.
A big part of a middle linebacker's job is being able to take on blocks and then go make plays. But the best ones, they have those big guys in front of them playing defensive line to hold blockers off of them and allow them to flow sideline to sideline and make the big hits.
The last run got 3, now here's 2nd and 7. Now they'll run it on the toss. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal. Only the Titans converted more red zone opportunities into touchdowns than the Packers last year, and they've got an opportunity here, first and goal. He pushes forward from maybe 3 down to the 6-yard line. He's hit pay dirt a lot this year, but not that time.
Yeah, I'm tracking right there with you. You're exactly right. He's found the end zone plenty of times. No way I can find any fault with the call. He may not have scored there. Of course you're going to give it to him.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
It's not easy playing the corner, is it? A lot of times you got to defend against the pass, but sometimes you have to play against the run. How about the job he did there, crashing inside to make that tackle for a loss?
Again, the ball carrier.
The Falcons send out their punter. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. The Falcons send out their punter. He's been terrific so far. This is taken at about the 14. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. And he's already gone over 200 yards on the ground as we get a look at some of his solid work.
And the guys I know, they think about 100 yards each and every game. That's the confidence factor. That's the level they think they should be getting to. Rarely do they admit to saying, I'm going to go for 200 or more in a game. That's what we're seeing right here. What a combination of great runs, vision, power, terrific blocking. It's all come together in this one.
And nearly impossible to stop. Foyesade Aluakon made the tackle there from his safety position. I think you'd have to say defensively, these guys are doing their job pretty well, right?
Yeah, we talked about them holding them under 20 points, right, on defense. And they've done that. They've held them. The problem is their own offense hasn't answered their challenge, which was to score more.
Yeah, exactly. I remember you saying magic number was right around 20, and the offense has been the issue. You're right. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
3 points separating these two. Football here as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. And I think this defense knew what was coming as he is smothered behind the line. And now we'll see a timeout used on defense as they stop it right out of the break with 1:57 to go in the ballgame. Second and 12, and you'd have to assume another all-out effort to stop the run is coming. To throw is Rodgers. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. Whistles now and a timeout. So defensively, they burn it here with 1:51 left. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Going to give this time to the tailback. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. So here we go, Charles, 3rd down. Any chance you throw him?
I don't think so. I think you got to keep the clock rolling here.
So out now comes the field goal unit for the Falcons. This to potentially send us to overtime. And this kick is not gonna get there. It's short and no good. Well, we looked at each other right. Rodgers to throw. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go.
And incomplete. A.J. Terrell on the coverage.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. So it looks like somebody may have forgotten the snap count, and a 5-yard penalty ensues.
Offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards. So after the penalty, heading in the wrong direction, second and 15. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 14-yard line. So 4 quarters wasn't enough, and we are off to overtime. Don't change that dial. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game. If they kick a field goal, though, or don't score, the other team gets a possession. And after both teams get a possession, then we're into sudden death. First team to score wins the game.
Seven past the 30 to the 32.
He's tackled it.
Not a bad idea to start overtime. Feed the hot hand.
And understand that when you're feeding that hot hand, everyone else is pretty much in agreement on it. You know, a team looks at their game and says, all right, who's playing really well? Let them touch the football, and we'll do our job to help them along.
And now we'll get a stoppage here. There appears to be an injured Falcon on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. He's had some big runs in this game. Not there, though.
But I don't think they're going to be deterred by that play right there. He's had some nice runs in the game, and how many times have we seen a good running back get stopped, yet turn it into something big on a later carry? I'd stay with him.
And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 13. First throw of overtime for Rodgers. He's got the hook up to Lazard. And he's into the end zone for the touchdown and the game winner in OT.
Touchdown, Packers.
Partner, great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get 4 quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted 4 quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.
So for the Packers, hey, they finish a perfect month of September as they move to 4-0 on the new campaign. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for Atlanta, they'll drop down to 1-3. And they'll be back home next week as they're set to take on the Carolina Panthers. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Yeah, ay, I use a dub. I'ma win. I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, I turn the knob, can't resist. I'm incredible. Yeah, I came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating around here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I whipped the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay, yeah, yeah. Can I hit that?
Ready for this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only winning is exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only winning is exception on my cool, yeah. Ain't no dub, ain't no L. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this.
Okay, yeah, yeah. Can I hit that?
Go ahead, just down like that.
Work the middle, work the middle.
know my name. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go, but I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah. Look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
Still got a reflux, I drip out from the socket to a teacup. Drink up inside, look when they peep us. Jesus in the belly of the beast, but outside there's a war going on your front lawn. Black Hawk, see the red dawn horizon. Blind yet I'm rising, abiding by laws of attraction. My thoughts still rising, thinking. What type of knowledge don't sink in? Life gives you lemons and my only thought is drinking. Thirsty, will I be alive or dead before 30? That's all that concerns me early. Lemonade quenching my inner rage when it takes center stage. Way before they pouring on my grave. Minute Maid, let it set my soul ablaze. On each and every wave, put me in the water for the save.
They don't know my name.
Got a block on lock.
I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she's saying white.